And then the another one is a spontaneous emission, and third one is a stimulated emission. So then our aim is to get stimulated emission of radiation. So that I already pointed out, to get a stimulated emission of radiation, the population inversion should be taken place. What is the population inversion? The number of atoms presented in the excited level should be greater than the number of atoms presented in the lower level. So that I have given in this slide, what is population inversion, which is that is N2 greater than N1. Number of atoms presented in the higher level must be greater than that of a lower level, it leads less reaction. This process can be analytically discussed through the construction of laser rate equation. How to construct the laser rate equation? Basic idea for constructing a rate equation. First, there are process emission and absorption. How to write the equation for a emission and absorption? So, for a first simple equation, whenever we are considering two energy levels, then according to the Planck's, the difference of energy level is equal to the h nu. So, it is we are telling it is a quanta. Here in this slide, I have given a E1 as a ground state, which is nothing but the rest state, which is a more stable, and E2 is a excited state, it is a temporary state. Why we are telling this a temporary state? That atom can only live for very small amount of period, that is in terms of a nanoseconds. And then we can say there is a total number of atoms in the assembly, we can say there is a n, which is nothing but the n1 plus n2. So, that is n1 and n2 are for a population of atoms in the first level and the second level. The basic process, three basic process: absorption first, when an atomic assembly is exposed for a light energy, first the ground level atoms will swallow those energy, that means that will absorb the energy and that will move to the ground level to the upper level. This process is called as stimulated absorption. Next, the excited atoms are the atoms presented in the second level can come automatically to the lower level after the completion of its lifetime. I already said that the lower level lifetime is very feeble, that is in the nanosecond. So, this within the period it will lose its lifetime and it will come down, and after in that result of this, there is a laser radiation, there is a emission, it is not a laser radiation, it is a emission. And third one is a attainment of a population inversion. Once number of atoms presented in the higher level is more, if you are applying a energy, a feeble energy if you are applying, then atoms will come down from the higher level to the lower level. Now, there are a number of photons will come out, these are triggered by means of a small input energy given to the system. So, this is a triggering, this emission is because of a triggering. So, this system is called as a stimulated emission of radiation. So, let me come to the point of writing the equation. So, this is purely a probability process. I do not know how much number of atoms will receive the energy, if suppose if I am giving energy to the system. It may be 100 atoms will receive the energy, or it may be 1000 atoms may receive the energy, or 1 million atom may receive the energy. It purely depends upon the input energy given, and then exposure time, and then the number of atoms present in the lower level. These all the parameters we have to take into account. So, then how we are writing the number of atoms going from the upper level, lower level to the upper level. So, here for that we have to write the decay of the state of population. This decay of a state of population can be named as a rate of change of a population, that is a rate of change of population in the second level may be written as a dN2 by dt, where N2 represent the number of atoms present in the second level, d by dt of the rate at which then N2 atoms are decaying. So that is normally depends on the number of atoms present in the higher level and as well as the lifetime of atoms present in the higher level. So then we can write the equation dN2/dt is equal to, that is the lifetime of atoms present in the level, that is a T21N2. In this expression I have put a minus sign in front of T21/N2. Why this minus sign is here? This is telling about the depopulation. Minus sign is for a depopulation. If you are putting a plus sign, it is for a population. So let me come to the point of our next rate equation for absorption and stimulated emission. That is for a stimulated emission I already gave this. So we are giving a pumping energy. That pumping energy is indicated by means of a WP. The rate at which coming down from the higher level to the lower level can be written as a dN2/dt, and then W, it is purely associated with the pumping energy and number of atoms presented, that can be written as a WpN2. So then we can say that is a sigma 2n, which is nothing but a stimulated emission cross section. That is all let it be, we can discuss later on. And then next is a similarly for absorption, how we can write d/dt of n1. That is our rate of change of atoms present in the first level is depend on these parameters. That means one is the lasing energy. That means if the energy is utilized to drop the atoms from the higher level to the lower level, that energy may be called as a lasing energy. And then WL and N1. So then we can write this equation. So normally when you are giving a pumping energy, that will be absorbed by means of a system and that will be taken to the upper level. So this is how the stimulated emission of radiation is taking place. See, see that I have given a only one atom to the excited medium. There is a cascading of atoms or coming, which are having the we can say that they are much fasting as a output. So single atom has been coming out with a many number of atoms when it is applied to the excited medium. This is the essence of the laser. The factor by which an input beam is amplified by a medium is called the gain and is represented by G. See that how laser operates. A laser, as there is a active medium, that is atoms which are telling the active medium, there are two mirrors on both the sides and there is oscillation in between the two mirror, and then after achieving the enough energy that will be come out. That's there are energy levels are given. So then now coming to the point of a rate equation for a two level system. Rate equation for a two level system, so there is a pumping level N1 and N2. The rate for change of a second level can be discussed in this way. The second level are proportional to these parameters. One is number of atoms presented in the accumulation of atoms in the second level is purely depends on the pumping energy and the number of atoms present in the first level. So the pumping energy accumulate the atoms in the second level, so this is positive. So we can write that is a PIN1. And then next term, atoms presented in the lower level may come to the first level. Then this is there are a possibility of atoms presented in the second level will come down. So here there is a depopulation, so we have to put a minus sign. So then accumulation of atoms in the first level due to the absorption is purely depends on the pumping energy and number of atoms presented in the first level. Decaying of atom is purely depends on pumping energy as well as number of atoms in the presented in the second level. So then accumulation is plus PIN1 and then depopulation minus PIN2. And after this there are a possibility of atoms presented in the higher level may come to the lower level spontaneously. So there also there is a negative sign. Then we can write the rate of change of a second level can be written as a dN2/dt BI in bracket N1 minus N2 minus AN2. Likewise, I can